Hello, you guys. Welcome back to the Fresh Host Monday. You know, it's always the hardest day, right? Monday, though. Oh, it's Monday. It's Monday. It's so hard. It's Monday. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, I shot the whole video yesterday, and then got caught up with the stuff I had to do yesterday. When I got back, in the morning I watched a bit of my game, that's what to do. This is like I'm gonna see it at least like the third quarter, like a little bit of third quarter. I saw the first, second, and a little bit of third quarter I had to do something. Okay. Watch the rest. I came back and I showed my video of the final score and all that. And it had Georgia stuff, so I was like, I forgot to upload, so I'm just gonna redo it here. Minnesota Vikings. We played a phenomenal game. I was so happy. Man. I was losing my goal. Jumping with joy. Every time we win, I always look at it. Every time we lose, it gets me ticked. But what can I say? It was a great way to end our Sunday, right? Victory. I don't know who we play next, but I think we might have a bye. If we have a bye week, then good. We might need one, but not really. We can just play our whole season without bye weeks, to be honest. I'll be much happy about that. So, let's get right into this thing. I'm going to probably start doing this from now on. I'm going out often. For my liking fans out there, I'm going to just run down all the games. Yes, I'm not using my data because I can't use it. I'll get in trouble, so I just screenshotted all the scores. I think I'm gonna start doing the whole score list here. It's right here, all scores. So, let's gonna run it down. If you're not here, just Vikings fans, you're gonna hear my video for football. You're not a Vikings fan, but you're like other football team. I'm gonna run down. So, Miami Dolphins beat the Atlanta Falcons 20-17. Week six, right? So, the Cleveland Browns lose again to the Cleveland Browns lose again. This time to Houston 33-17. So that makes them 0-6. The Detroit Lions, I'm so happy about this one. Detroit Lions lose 38-52. And I gotta say something when I talk about this, but we'll get right into it. Hold on. The San Francisco 49ers are 0-6 now. They lose to the Washington Redskins by 2 points by safety. The Rams looking pretty good. The Los Angeles Rams are looking pretty good. Final score is 27-17 over the Jags in Jacksonville, Florida. Next, the Los Angeles Chargers, the non-fan-based Chargers. So nobody, I saw a report that nobody in San Diego or in LA are going to watch the Chargers. I heard. They beat the Oakland Raiders 17-16. By 1 point, by field goal, I guess, because when I came back, my dad had the game on. And he's like, oh yeah, the Raiders missed the field goal or something, a bad play. So that's how the Chargers won. Next, we have the Chicago Bears. Beat the Baltimore Ravens. 27-24 in overtime. You know, Mr. Bisky probably had a good game, but I don't really care. Because they overhyped this guy, overpraised Mr. Trubisky like some kind of god, like literally. John Gruden, the guy from Monday Night Football and does his camps. He overly hypes this guy like it's some kind of god, you know, like a new rookie coming in the game. I think talking about him, I think Brett Hundley has had a better game, to be honest. I really see Brett Hundley, I know all of them are hating, but Brett Hundley's going to be a star in the NFL. When Aaron Rodgers leaves, he's going to be a star. I watch it because I'm a UCLA fan for basketball and football. And I watch literally his whole entire UCLA career. And it's a good one. He had a good career in his he's gonna make any second in the NFL, so I'm happy for that. So anyways, we'll skip this next one because we're gonna talk. Next one was our game. Said that New England Patriots win over the Jets. The Jets gave them a run for their money. I have to say the Jets gave them a run for their money. That was a game to watch. The Jets gave them a run for their money. And the Arizona Cardinals, you guys know Adrian Peterson got traded from New Orleans because he barely did much to Arizona. I guess he had a burst out game like 100 something yards. I guess he had a big game. And they beat Tampa Bay Buccaneers 38-33. Then we had the final rematch of the playoffs from last year, Kansas City and Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh beats Kansas City 19-13. Right there. Then we had Denver and the Giants. The Giants are now not winless. They finally won their first game. And it was against the Denver Broncos. I think Denver Broncos had two losses. Two or three losses. They beat them 23-10. Way to go, Giants. But anyways, not to our game. And like I was saying, when I said the Lions lost, and we beat the Packers. That's a big thing, you know. The two of the best teams in our division are Lions Packers. So now the Packers and us have the same record. But I was like so happy that two of the third and fourth place are kind of the bottom low teams in the division was us and the Bears, and we both won. Oh, the two of the best first, second place best teams lost. And that was a good thing, you know. It's two divisional wins for us. And one divisional loss. We beat the Bears on Monday night, last Monday, to wrap up week 5. And we just beat the Packers yesterday to wrap up, week 6 ends today, but week 6. So that makes us two divisional wins. Then we lost to, and the week after the Bears, after we got to the Bears, we lost the Lions by a touchdown. So that gives the first divisional loss. But anyways, we win the game 23-10. Did somebody win the game? Oh, yeah, was it the Giants? Yeah, it was just like the Giants, 23-10. Hey, Giants, welcome. 23-10. We threw for 351 total yards, 239 passing yards. We went 24 for 38. You guys know, AJ Pearson did break his collarbone or some kind of collarbone area. So I don't know, he might be done for the whole season or not. Maybe it's a crazy one. We'll see. And they went for 247 yards, 175 passing yards, 20 for 37. We went for 112 rushing yards and 102 rushing yards. Case Keenum went for 239 yards, one interception, one touchdown, 24 for 38. Jerry McKinnon. I have no words for Jerry McKinnon because you know what? He just had an amazing game, burst out game from the beginning to the end. Like literally, from start to finish, he had a burst out game. I think he's the only one that touched him. You know, Eric Kendricks, Trey Wayne, 6 tackles, huge. Harrison Smith. You know, played good. Newman, all those guys. Griffin, 2 tackles. Rhodes, 2 tackles. Everybody had a phenomenal game. Joseph and all them, 1 tackle. But it doesn't matter who stepped up. And I want to talk about the Packers. Not all of them, just the quarterbacks. Aaron Rodgers gets hurt. He went for 2 for 4, 18 yards. Okay, I say, like I told you guys in my video, if Bradford would have started the game, even if Aaron Rodgers wouldn't have hurt, or if he was hurt, we still would have lost the game, even if Brett Hundley was their quarterback. I'm telling y'all the truth. I am telling y'all the truth. There's a dog on the leash. Telling the truth, that's the truth. Even if Brett Hundley would have started the game, we still would have lost. Because Bradford was 100% running. I told you guys. If Case Keenum comes into the game, sorry again. If Case Keenum doesn't come into the game, we would have lost. Case Keenum came into the game, would have won. And guess what? He started the game and finished the game. And we won. So Brett Hundley went for 18 for 33, 157 yards, 3 interceptions, and 1 touchdown. I'm telling you. You think Mitchell Trubisky is all hype, you know? Brett Hundley got drafted in 2015. Barely got starts, maybe preseason. Not really much of preseason or regular season. I'm telling you, he's gonna just see next week. I don't think Aaron Rodgers is gonna start next week, that's for sure. I mean, maybe not for the whole of the season, you know, who knows. I'm telling you right now, it's the truth. But yeah, we won the game. I'm just so relieved, happy, and how well we played, you know. 23-10. This is a huge win for us, to be honest. And then now, the Packers and us have the same record, so we're basically tied. I want to say for second place, I think. And the Lions are still first, if I'm not mistaken. Which I'm not fucking mistaken, but anyways. Overall, phenomenal performance. We stepped up in this game huge. I mean huge. Like I told you guys, the whole Bradford situation. If Sam Bradford wouldn't have been a quarterback, we totally would have lost. We totally would have lost. He wasn't ready, you know, when he saw the game against the Browns, he threw a couple plays, and he grabbed his knee. And so when he grabbed his knee, that doesn't mean they're ready, you know? The knee, we should call him Knee Grabbing Bradford. I think he can grab his knee for days. He's probably still throwing some stuff in practice, but it ain't enough to be game worthy ready. It's more practice worthy ready, you know? If you're the knee grabber, I'm sorry. I think you're not gonna get the start. Yeah, basically, what I'm trying to tell y'all. But anyways, overall great performance. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. How do you think we did? Did you like the performance, or it could have been better? Or it wasn't the best performance I've seen? Leave it down in the comments down below. I'd like to know. I thought it was a really good one so far for week 6. I don't know who you're playing week 7. If you're probably not gonna look that up. If you guys know, before we look it up, leave it down in the comment section down below. But time you probably put in the comment section, I'll probably know who we play. And that video will probably be up Thursday like usual. And yeah, so we guys have a great week. We're almost close to Halloween, right? Get your candy. I might not get candy out here, but who knows? Because where I live, a lot of people don't trick or treat where I live, because not that much kids in my apartment complex area where I live. So. I'm just letting y'all know that we don't, like last year, nobody came to our doors, had candy for days, but my dad just gave it when he went to his office, to get it all working in his office. Because we're not really candy eaters anymore, you know? We're all in the fitness stuff, we're all into losing weight, not to just a scarf down chocolate bar and candy all day, you know what I'm saying? I love Halloween. That's the only one day I can eat candy, and that's it, and the rest, we go back to regular lives and just eating clean, right? Right? I think so. Eating clean lifestyle, you know what I mean? Go. Go. It's still there, I think. Alright, kinda killed us. It's slowly dying there, though. It's a little like waspy. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this video. Let me know what you think about our performance. That was a really awesome performance. We came out there with our heads held high, guns blazing. Jeremy McKinnon was fired up. I don't blame him. You know, Adam Thielen had great receiving, and so did Kyle Rudolph. So did our players. Red Nose Rudolph had a great receive. So overall, we had some great receiving plays. But we got this is only one of the many that we were going to play the Packers. We're going to play the Packers maybe two, or at least three, even about maybe two more times, maybe three. So, the road didn't stop here. Let's keep on going. Like I was saying, everybody just keep going. Let's go Vikings. Let's do this. Let's win. And I'll see y'all later. Bye, y'all. Have a good Monday. Keep your heads up high. And we got this where we play week 7.